하루 한번 영어 성경 암송. 이번 시간에는 누가복음 18장 27절 말씀입니다. Luke 18 verse 27. But he said. 여기서 he는 우리 예수님을 가리키죠. 그렇죠? 예수님께서 말씀하셨습니다. What is impossible with man? impossible이란 말은 형용사로 불가능한 이런 뜻이고요. 그 밑에 나오는 possible, 가능한의 반대말이죠. 그래서 What is impossible with man? 인간한테 불가능한 것이 is possible with God. 하나님께는 가능하니라. 이렇게 되겠죠? 자, 연습해 보시겠습니다.
Luke 18 verse 27. Luke 18 verse 27. Luke 18 verse 27. But he said, "What is impossible with man is possible with God." Luke 18 verse 27. Luke 18 verse 27. But he said, "What is impossible with man is possible with God." Luke 18 verse 27. Luke 18 verse 27. But he said, "What is impossible with man is possible with God." Luke 18 verse 27. Focus on the lines and recite them. But he said, "What is impossible with man?" is possible with God. But he said, "What is impossible with man is possible with God." But he said, "What is impossible with man?" is possible with God. Again, focus on the line and recite it. But he said, "What is impossible with man But he said, "What is impossible with man?" But he said, "What is impossible with man is possible with God." Is possible with God. Is possible with God. Focus on the entire verse and recite it. Luke 18, verse 27. But he said, "What is impossible with man is possible with God." Luke 18, verse 27. Luke 18, verse 27. But he said, "What is impossible with man is possible with God." Luke 18, verse 27. Luke 18, verse 27. But he said, what is impossible with man is possible with God. Luke 18, verse 27.
"하루 한번 영어 성경 암송." 이번 시간에는 에베소서 6장 2절 말씀입니다. Ephesians 6 verse 2. Honor your father and mother. Honor라는 말이 이제 공경하다, 존경하다 이런 뜻이죠. 네 아비와 어미를 공경하라. This is the first commandment. Commandment는 명령이에요. 또는 계명이 되겠죠. With a promise라고 되어 있는데 명사로 쓰인 약속입니다. 그래서 이것이 약속 있는 첫 번째 계명입니다. 전체 보실까요? Honor your father and mother, 네 아비와 어미를 공경하라. This is the first commandment with a promise. 이것이 약속 있는 첫 번째 계명입니다. 이렇게 되죠? 같이 한번 연습해 보시겠습니다.
Ephesians 6 verse 2. Ephesians 6 verse 2. Ephesians 6 verse 2. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Ephesians 6 verse 2. Ephesians 6 verse 2. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Ephesians 6 verse 2. Ephesians 6 verse 2. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Ephesians 6 verse 2. Center your thoughts on the lines and quote them. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Again, center your thoughts on the line and quote it. Honor your father and mother. Honor your father and mother. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. This is the first commandment with a promise. This is the first commandment with a promise. Center your thoughts on the entire verse and quote it. Ephesians 6, verse 2. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Ephesians 6, verse 2. Ephesians 6, verse 2. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Ephesians 6, verse 2. Ephesians 6, verse 2. Honor your father and mother. This is the first commandment with a promise. Ephesians 6, verse 2.
A 하루 한번 영어 성경 암송. 이번 시간에는 골로새서 3장 14절 말씀입니다. Colossians 3 verse 14. And above all these 라고 되어 있죠. 그래서 above all 하면은 무엇보다도 이런 얘기죠. 그래서 이것보다 더해 from love 사랑을 놓거라. 그래서 이 모든 것에 더해서 사랑을 놓거라. Which 그것은 이 사랑을 받는 말이죠. Binds는 묶다, 매다 이런 뜻이에요. Everything together, together는 함께죠. 모든 것을 함께 묶는 것이니라. In perfect, perfect는 완벽한 이런 뜻이고, harmony는 조화죠. 그래서 완벽한 조화로 이렇게 되겠네요. 전체 다시 보시면 above all these, 이 모든 것 위에 put on love, 사랑을 두거라. Which, 그것은 binds everything together in perfect harmony, 모든 것을 완벽한 조화로 묶는 것이니라. 이렇게 되겠죠? 연습해 보시겠습니다.
Colossians 3 verse 14. Colossians 3 verse 14. Colossians 3 verse 14. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3 verse 14. Colossians 3 verse 14. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3 verse 14. Colossians 3 verse 14. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3 verse 14. Center your thoughts on the lines and quote them. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Again, center your thoughts on the line and quote it. And above all these, put on love. And above all these, put on love. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Center your thoughts on the entire verse and quote it. Colossians 3 verse 14. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3 verse 14. Colossians 3 verse 14. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3 verse 14. Colossians 3, verse 14. And above all these, put on love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. Colossians 3, verse 14.
"하루 한번 영어 성경 암송. 이번 시간에는 에베소서 4장 26절 말씀입니다. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Be angry. Angry는 이제 화난 이런 뜻이죠. 그래서 화를 내고 and do not sin. sin은 죄짓다예요. 그래서 분을 내도 죄짓지는 마시오 이런 얘기죠. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. 당신의 화로 해가 지도록 그렇게 내버려 두지 마시오라는 얘기는 분을 내되 해 떨어지기까지 그렇게 하지 말라라는 얘기죠. 전체 보시면 Be angry and do not sin. 자, 분을 내어도 죄는 짓지 말고 Do not let the sun go down on your anger. 자, 해가 지도록 분을 품지 마시오. 이런 정도 의미가 되겠네요. 연습해 보시겠습니다.
Ephesians 4 verse 26. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Devote your attention to the lines and say them. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Again, devote your attention to the line and say it. Be angry and do not sin. Be angry and do not sin. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Devote your attention to the entire verse and say it. Ephesians 4, verse 26. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Ephesians 4 verse 26. Ephesians 4, verse 26. Be angry and do not sin. Do not let the sun go down on your anger. Ephesians 4, verse 26.
Haru hanbon yeongho seonggyeong hamseong. Ibon siganeneun Yohangeshirok 20장 15절 말씀입니다. Revelation 20 verse 15. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, 자, if는 만약 이런 뜻이죠. 그래서 만약 어떤 이의 name, 이름이 was not found 했는데 발견되지 않다 이런 뜻이죠. be found가 발견되자인데 written이면 쓰여진 이런 뜻입니다. 그래서 in the book of life, 생명책에 이름이 씌워진 걸로 발견되지 않으면 he was thrown, be thrown 하면은 던지우다 이런 뜻이죠. throw가 던지다인데 throw는 과거분사예요. 수동태로 되어 있죠. into the lake of fire, lake가 호수니까 lake of fire 하면 불못이 되겠죠. 그는 불못에 던졌느니라 이렇게 되죠. 전체 보면 and if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, 만약에 어떤 이의 이름이 생명책에 기록되어 발견되지 않으면 he was thrown into the lake of fire, 그는 불못에 던졌느니라 이렇게 되겠죠. 같이 연습해 보실까요?
Revelation 20 verse 15. Revelation 20 verse 15. Revelation 20 verse 15. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. Revelation 20 verse 15. Revelation 20 verse 15. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. Revelation 20 verse 15. Revelation 20 verse 15. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. Revelation 20 verse 15. Devote your attention to the lines and say them. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. again, devote your attention to the line and say it. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, and if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, and if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. He was thrown into the lake of fire. He was thrown into the lake of fire. Devote your attention to the entire verse and say it. Revelation 20, verse 15. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. Revelation 20, verse 15. Revelation 20, verse 15. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. Revelation 20, verse 15. Revelation 20, verse 15. And if anyone's name was not found written in the book of life, he was thrown into the lake of fire. Revelation 20, verse 15.
"하루 한번 영어 성경 암송. 이번 시간에는 히브리서 13장 8절 말씀입니다. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same. 예수 그리스도는 the same. 같으십니다. Yesterday, 어제나, and today, 오늘이나, and forever, 영원히. 이렇게 되겠죠? 그래서 예수 그리스도는 어제나, 오늘이나, 영원히 같으십니다. 이렇게 되겠죠. 연습해 보십니다.
Hebrews 13 verse 8. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13 verse 8. Listen to the line and repeat it. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Again, listen to the line and repeat it. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Listen to the entire verse and repeat it. Hebrews 13, verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13, verse 8. Hebrews 13, verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13, verse 8. Hebrews 13, verse 8. Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever. Hebrews 13, verse 8.
Haru hanbon yeongeo seonggyeong hamsung. 이번 시간에는 잠언서 12장 22절 말씀입니다. Proverbs 12 verse 22. Lying lips. 자, lying은 이제 거짓말하는 이런 뜻이에요. 거짓말하는 lip은 입술이죠. 거짓말하는 입술은 an abomination to the Lord 했는데 abomination 이거는 혐오스러운 것 이렇게 돼요. 그래서 거짓말하는 입은 to the Lord 여호와께 혐오스러운 것이나 but 그러나 those who 하면은 이게 뭐뭐하는 사람들 이렇게 되죠. act는 행동하다고요. faithfully 부사로 충실하게 이런 뜻이죠. 그리고 충실하게 행하는 이들은 are his delight 그분의 기쁨이니라 이렇게 됩니다. 전체 보시면 lying lips are an abomination to the Lord. 거짓말하는 입술은 여호와께 혐오스러운 것이나 but 그러나 those who act faithfully 자 충실하게 행동하는 이들은 are his delight 그분의 기쁨입니다 이렇게 되겠죠. 자 연습해 보실까요?
Proverbs 12 verse 22 Proverbs 12 verse 22 Proverbs 12 verse 22 Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but those who act faithfully are His delight. Proverbs 12 verse 22 Proverbs 12 verse 22 Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but those who act faithfully are His delight. Proverbs 12 verse 22 Proverbs 12 verse 22 Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but those who act faithfully are His delight. Proverbs 12 verse 22 Focus on the lines and recite them. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord. But those who act faithfully are His delight. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord. But those who act faithfully are His delight. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord. But those who act faithfully are His delight. Again, focus on the line and recite it. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord. But those who act faithfully are His delight. But those who act faithfully are His delight. But those who act faithfully are His delight. Focus on the entire verse and recite it. Proverbs 12, verse 22. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but those who act faithfully are His delight. Proverbs 12, verse 22. Proverbs 12, verse 22. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but those who act faithfully are His delight. Proverbs 12, verse 22. Proverbs 12, verse 22. Lying lips are an abomination to the Lord, but those who act faithfully are His delight. Proverbs 12, verse 22.